Hello Geminis, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you and your person. So on one side we have your energies, on other side we have the energies of the person you are dealing with it, and then the most likely outcome. So let's see what we have for Geminis. Okay, wow, we have the devil on your side. Let's see what you have on your person's side. The page of pentacles, okay. The most likely outcome. Okay, we have the six of wands as the most likely outcome. So as far as these three cards are concerned, with the devil card on your side, either you are obsessed by this person or you are being very dominating or being very controlling. So there is, it's not very good. It's not a very positive thing. But whatever it is, that it has to be put to check. With the devil card, maybe you are being very, very controlling, being very spying them too much, or they should tell you everything, whatever they are doing, something like that. It's not a very positive thing, but yes, something is there which needs to be corrected here on your side, Geminis. But you are definitely in a relationship which is, there is some sort of toxicity sort of to it. So negativity is attached to it. Okay, and here with the page of pentacles, as far as your person is concerned, this person is ready for a new beginning. They're ready for a new beginning and maybe stepping up in some way, shape or form. With the six of wands as the most likely outcome, it is victory, it is celebration. So definitely it's a positive card. Happiness is there, celebration is there, achievement is there in this relationship. So let's see, why is this devil here for on your side? So we have the nine of cups, the ten of cups and the judgment. Okay. Let's see, why is this page of pentacles here for on your person side? So we have the king of swords, the high priestess and the queen of wands. Okay. Let's see what's there behind the six of wands. Okay, the two of swords, the ace of swords, the star. Okay. So as far as the thing behind the devil is concerned, what I am getting here is that you have stumbled in a relationship in the past perhaps, and you are trying to align your life. Things were scattered, things were spoiled, they were not in control. You had lost control in some way, shape or form, and you are trying to align your life. You're trying to put your cups together. You're trying to sort out your life together. Okay. And with the judgment, this is something actually you are really wishing for. You want to align your life. That's what I'm getting. You've really stumbled in the past badly. You've really slipped or stumbled in the past very, very badly. You were just all over the place. Everything was lost. Everything was bad. Things were out of your control. And now you just want to streamline your life. And that is what you earnestly want. Okay, so that is the negative thing. Because you're scared, you have that negative experience of being lost. Things were not under your control. And you've really stumbled in the past. And it was huge. It's really tough for you to align your life. But you really wish to align your life right now. One more thing is, you want to, it's like coming off as if you want to sew the, you want to tailor the your life, your relationship, you want to tailor them up. You want to sew them up. You want to get things together. You want to get back to the things. Perhaps you are trying to mend an old relationship, which perhaps for some reason was broken, or there were problems in that relationship. Perhaps you are trying to sew that relationship, or trying to knit it together or sort it out. So it's coming off as you're trying to weave a relationship or your life once again. Beautiful. And here we have the King of Swords, the High Priestess, and the Queen of Wands. So what I'm getting here is that definitely, though we have the Page of Pentacles stepping up, but then over here this person has a withered, is struggling, really struggling, having a tough life, dealing with a lot of struggles and having a tough life. Okay, so they do have a past. They have a really struggle type of a thing in their life. They've struggled a lot. And with the High Priestess and the Queen of Wands, what I feel is this person is taking their time. This person is taking the time, being very, very intuitive as far as stepping up is concerned. Yeah. So they will go slow. Perhaps they are going slow. Whosoever this person is, they are very, very intuitive, not acting, not taking any action as such. Being very, very intuitive. And here, though we have the Six of Wands here, but as the clarifiers, we have the Two of Swords, the Ace of Swords, and the Star. So what I am getting here is, the Six of Wands, it's not happening right now. It's the energy which you want, both of you want. Okay, so this is what both of you are working for. You want the Six of Wands, you want happiness, you want to celebrate, and that is what I've already said. This person is not making much moves, and you are also trying to weave the relationship perhaps with this person, or if it is a new person, then you are trying to weave your life back again in some way, shape, or aligning it. And with the Two of Wands, Swords here, both of you, and with the Ace of Swords, Star. It's like, you know, both of you are working for it, both of you know, but you are not speaking. It's sort of that. It's a wish, you want this wish to be fulfilled, but both of you are being very, very intuitive, not taking much action, trying to sort it out in your head first. Okay, both of you are trying to sort it out in your head first and aligning the relationship and how to go about it, sort of aligning your life first of all individually, trying to sort out things. And since it is your wish fulfillment and outcome is Six of Wands, so perhaps you will be able to do it. At least you want it, you want it, you want this to work. Actually, this, you want this to work, be it a new relationship, be it somebody from the past, whatever it is. But here you've stumbled over something and you're trying to align it. Maybe it's an old relationship or your life itself in a new way, and that is your earnest wish. And this person is also doing the same thing. They are not making a move. They are trying to they are very intuitive, and they're trying to sort things out to get the answers within as to what to do, sort of, because they have a terrible past, they have a terrible life here. So this person is also very, very guarded. They don't want to get hurt again. And here mutual energy also is the same. Both of you want this to work or happen, but both of you are taking that time. It's good, not bad. It's the right thing. And here as a, let's see what is the guidance from the universe. Okay, the only thing that is real is love. Number 7 may be of some significance. We shift your focus back to love. So that is what both of you need to do. Okay, the real thing is love. If you want to work on it, you will be able to work on it. You have to focus on the positivity. You have to focus on the good aspects of each other rather than focusing on what had happened or what spoiled it, if it was the past. Or if it was your life individually, then whatever has gone wrong has gone wrong. You need to focus on the positives. Only then you will be able to sort it out. So Gemini, it seems to be a very powerful reading, but and a good reading also. So that's all I have for you. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I just hope it helps. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.